two things, like I just said, is staying determined and staying focused. Another one is, what's the main thing is, when you get an opportunity, making the most of them. Because a lot of people get opportunities and they slack on them, or they don't take them as seriously as they should. And one reason why I'm here today is that I had an opportunity and I made the most of it.
They say a good role model won't tell you, they'll show you. Fab, I don't know you, but there's hella shit I owe you. Never really local, shit just started going global. Remember when I seen you, when I just had to approach you at the Kia Shine video shoot, nigga came through. I had on Rich Young with some Timberland boots. I could smell the weed on him, more than likely he was blunted. With a pretty lady in them Nikes that I wanted, keep it 100. I was starstruck for a minute, got too many bitches that had as much love for a nigga. Y'all might say I'm tripping, on the real I'm just being honest. I'm not a crazy ass fan, I'm just paying homage to the most consistent artist in this game. How could y'all blame this nigga? I'm just wanting the same. I remember I was bumping Street Dreams for the fam. Had me like da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-damn. And then you hit us with real talk. Crazy, it changed me, cause honestly, real talk raised me. Truth is, you have always been one of my favorites, but I vividly remember that time that you played me. Coming out of Nordstrom, had to say what's up. Soon as I spoke, you replied, what the fuck you want?
What you mean, what I want? That's how you talk to me, Holmes, knowing I probably got the soul tape paused on my phone.
But shit, I ain't tripping, probably caught you at a bad time. Just showing love, you can miss me with the bad vibes. The last time that I reach out, niggas won't single me out. Just keep killing beats and putting heat out, staying that relevant, that's a blessing. From an artist's perspective, young OG, dog, you a legend. I ain't grow up on Pac and Biggie, just Ja and 50, when the game belonged in New York City. That Traded All remix with Diddy, one of the hardest. Ain't a song to this day you dropped I thought was garbage. And shit, I'm just honest, plus you never in no drama. I don't never see you arguing with fans in your comments. For that I promise that'll be me never. I studied your ways, but real shit, I'm trying to be better, trying to re-level, stay sharp, trying to be clever. If I could decide, you'd be top five forever.
Sometimes you gotta give credit when credit is due. A lot of people have like debates and arguments about who's the greatest. You know, they gonna bring up Pac, Biggie, Jay and Nas, but these niggas is like the greatest by default. Like, you can't not say these niggas' names, because you know, technically these niggas is the greatest. But to me, I feel like, nah, I got a different selection. You know, Joe Budden, Fab, like these is my favorite rappers. But Fab just always been clever with it, always coming with the shit like that. Had me like, damn, why the fuck I ain't think of that shit? You know what I'm saying? Like, son never in the tabloids. Never see this nigga looking crazy on the Shade Room. And as an artist, that's the type of shit that you admire, type of shit that you look up to. And that's why I always fucked with him. Plus, the nigga always fly as shit. Like, come on now. Just fuck it. Just make your music and get the bread. Like, that's really it. But I ain't gonna lie, though. Like, I was dead ass working at Nordstrom Rack. This is a true ass story. I ain't gonna lie. I was working at Nordstrom Rack. And son, I guess he was leaving out of the little nail salon. Cause I seen him over there a few times. But this time, I'm like, man, fuck it. Let me just holler at him. You know what I'm saying? He had his little bodyguards and shit with him. I walked up to him and I'm like, yo, what's good? You know, he hit me with a little quick glance back. And he's like, yo, what the fuck you want from me? And instantly, the crazy shit is, like, I wasn't even offended. I just heard it when he said, what the fuck you want from me? Like, I just started thinking of that verse. Like, what the fuck you want from me? I know what the fuck you want from me. But that's just me as a fan. So, you know, I just let that shit slide. I ain't really trip on it. You know, I kind of laugh because I'm like, shit, you know, fuck it, I'm not no fucking superstar. Nigga, I work at Nordstrom Rack. Maybe fucking fans running up to you every day get annoying sometimes, so I let it slide. But I knew in the back of my head that when I make it, I'm just gonna have this story, and I was gonna tell him this story. And he was like, oh shit, my nigga, I ain't know, my bad.